Lavender is another one that I've always loved making and adding to my bouquets. It is, you know, that burst of purple, but it also brings back memories of living in the Pacific Northwest and going to the Lavender Festival in Squim, Washington. It's on the Olympic Peninsula. And if you ever get a chance to go, it is breathtaking to see the fields of purple and white. Lavender does come in white, so you could do these in white as well. I'm going to do them in purple, and I'm going to, this one also has the added bonus of I've done a mason jar or a glass jar. You know, in the South here where I live now, mason jars are used for everything. We drink with them. We put bouquets in them. They've even got special tops on them now that you can even plug them into your blender. So they've become quite versatile. So I thought it was a great way to display the lavender. Before we get to the lavender, let's see how I do this. So this is the die, and I've cut two. I've cut one out of watercolor paper and one out of, this really is acetate that I've backed with on my Xyron machine, and I'll peel that off in a minute, but I'm going to paint this. You know, I just take a little bit of, I'll show you my watercolor tray here. And I'm just going to use a water brush. It's got, you know, it's got the water already in it. And just give myself a water line across. And you know what? I'm going to spritz this a bit first. There we go. And we'll get some bleeding. There we go. More water. Now, I did it a little bit darker because as it dries, it's going to lighten a bit. So, and you can see that beautiful design that I put into the glass jar. You could have done this, or I could have done this, you know, in white, or, you know, it could have just been a glass jar that you wanted to do it. So I'm going to leave that. I think that's probably enough of the blue. Maybe do a little line around here so it's a little bit darker. And we're going to let that dry while we work on the lavender. So for the lavender, I have a stem of nothing but the flowers, and then I have the leaves included on this stem. And as you can see, I've already done one here where I've added just a little bit of lavender growing up the stem. It hasn't bursted all the way yet. Now, the way I do this, because I like to get, as you can see, you know, variation in color. So I take some of my specialty cardstock, and, you know, here's surprising. These both say violet, and yet one has more reddish and one's more blue. So I don't know what went on there. But I'm just going to color my paper, and I'm just rubbing it with color. And since this one's a little different color and I had some of that reddish in there, I'm going to put that on there too. Now, you do need to color the back, but it's not, you know, it goes very quickly. And you can use distressed ink as well. Just don't use distressed oxide because it will, with the metal on the tools, it will react with it. I could leave that dark, but I'm going to put a little bit of the red in here and cover any of the white areas. And that's all there is to it. Just coloring, you know, a small piece of paper. This is probably like 4.5 by 5.25 or something. And then you've got a plate that says cut 6 times. And literally, I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that will do a full stem of lavender on front and back. And we've still got on this one, I've got the front to do. And it will do 2 stems easily. And you can even add, you know, it'll even give you more to add on top in case they flatten a bit so you get some dimension. So again, I've cut these out of watercolor paper because they are a little sturdier. And since they're going to have the bulk of the little flowerettes on it, I wanted something more substantial. So I'm just using YG 8.5 as a good green here to color the stems with the leaves and the stems with the flowers. And really didn't add too much shading. This is just a one color process. And then I'm going to go over this one too. So I always do front and back because you don't have a white side. You want it, this one on the card, I'll have to show you, I did it somewhat uniquely to stand above. Now I'm going to use something, it's not in my toolkit, but I really like it. It's a speedball mat, and you can find it in the art stores. I know some of the retail stores have started carrying them, but it's really good for these thicker pieces like the watercolor paper. If I want to get a nice vein line down, I'm doing that right on this speedball mat. And see, it even curls back my petals a bit in, or my leaves, really makes it look more natural. Luckily, there's no veins. It's just that stem line down the center. There we go. So I cut out my plate six times, and I do is put them on what's called a moo block. Now, these were used to cut stamps from, or cut your own stamps if you did that sort of thing a few years back. I find with these little pieces, you really need this sturdier surface. Now, if you can't find the move blocks, you can use just a regular eraser. I grab these art erasers at the art store, and they're pretty firm. So they would work as well too. I wouldn't use the speedball. It is a little softer and it will kind of sink in, but you're just simply going to use your small ball stylus and cup each one of these little guys, these little flowerettes. And then what I like to do is, again, I'm not going to use my silly pot. I'm going to, let's see, I'm going to finish this one here first. So I put a little bit of glue on a lid, and I'm going to use my detailed tweezers. I like to, I'll put this way here. So just pick them up, make sure you can see. Now, I already did cover the wrong side, or the reverse side. I'll show you. I do like to cover both, because in this instance, this is going to stand up above the ball or the mason jar. So you want to make sure you cover both sides. It's going to, be loose. So you're actually going to see both sides sometimes. And the project I designed with it to go today, definitely these are rising above the card base. So it's got little, like little calyxes there holding it. So I just go above that and place these. Now I'm just lightly dipping and putting them in place. You might want to have a toothpick on hand. Sometimes you get a little bit of glue on your tweezer and see it'll stay. And so this helps like a second hand without pressing down on it. But the glue adheres pretty quickly. This is the kid's choice, so that I've always used. And this is very relaxing. It's kind of like the spirea, the hyacinth, even the hydrangea, where you're just, once you color and cut them out, and you're just sitting here and placing them on your stem. So once you get the flower stem all completed, I might, I'm still going to have plenty that I can go back. I see where some of these, the glue had flattened a little bit, but you can go back and add a little bit more dimension to it in places. I know I have plenty because that's why I specified cutting it 6 times. So you can make them as full as you want and give them, you know, really a lot of dimension here. Okay, now for this little leaf stem, I've also gone ahead and hit those places, those little, almost like little stem areas that you can see. And now on the front, I'm going to go ahead and add some. Same way, just taking and adding a little bit of glue and placing some in a little cluster on those little branch protrusions there. Now you can do, I'm only doing a small bouquet, but this would be beautiful in a large bouquet and tied with a bow as well. You don't have to use the jar, but it's also a nice filler. I always like to give you ones that, if I can get that off, there we go. Ones that will fill in on your bouquets because you want height as well as the dimension. So, you know, this gives you that, would be lovely with, you know, even the magnolia that I did earlier. It would be pretty with the contrast with the white and the purples. I think I cut even an extra bunch here, but you know, I might still go back and add some once I put it on my project. So that's the stem and the leaf branches. And now let's finish our project. So I have the watercolor piece. Grab these a second. I'm going to grab a pen or a pencil. Let's grab a pencil. So I know these are going to lay in here. In fact, I might put this on my project because I made this card a little bit shorter so I could, it'll come out to be a 5x7, but I'm going to lay these in place first. And since I've got a grid on my glass mat here, I can tell where the 2 inches above. This is a 5x5 card, and so I'm going to just mark these areas with a pencil. So I know that stem's going to come down here, and that one's going to come down there. So just lightly know that's where those two stems are going to be. And you can draw it as, you know, I just like to make it look like it is in the bottle the way it is. I'm going to pull that up a little bit because there's the 2-inch mark up there. And then this one, let me pick it up. I lay these down here. It's kind of hard when you're not gluing them down yet. There we go. I guess I could hold it down with a piece of non-stick tape here. Let's see. Just make sure on even your tacky tape, take some of the tackiness off by, you know, rubbing it on your, either a sweater or I have on a flannel shirt. I'm just going to stick that down so I know where it's going to be. And then this one here, Again, I want to line that up so it's 5 because I'm going to do this at a 5x7 card. So this one needs to come here. And again, I'm going to draw a little line and then I know those are going to come down like that. The reason I'm doing this and taking the time to is I'm going to grab a, this is just a colored pencil for now, but it'll show through, and you want to do your lines coming down. So you've got stem lines showing in your, on your jar. I'm going to take the acetate that I've run through my Xyron and line it up. Hopefully. There we go. Gives it that glassy kind of look. Now I'm bending it to give it some dimension. And what I'm going to do is grab a little bit of glue here. Put in the center right there. And I'm going to put a foam dot on it. This will help keeping it pushed out. And the reason why I'm putting a little bit of glue is, you know, sometimes this foam dries, I have found. And so if you want to make sure it stays in place, go ahead and put a little bit of glue. Now I'm also going to put some glue in places where I know I want the jar to, you know, adhere to my project. So I will place it here. I'm going to push down on that. And as you can see, if I turn it this way, you can see I've got that dimension in the center. Now I'm going to hold this for a second and then we'll fill it. You can see if it takes longer because this is a thicker piece, I've just put a couple of clips on it to hold it in place while I'm placing the flowers. So I'm going to put some glue on this stem and slide it down in between, trying to, again, here's my 5-inch mark. Line it up like that. Here's my other one. Sliding it right down where I didn't put any glue at the top. I may do that in a little bit, but actually I'm going to put that one that way. And that way. There. Those were my two outer petals. And I can see where I'll put some glue in a second. And then I'm going to glue the flowers down. I'm going to go up a little bit higher, I think, just to make sure it catches. I'll put this one in front here. Oops. Let's see if I move it down. Yeah, I meant about 5. I'll take these off. And see, that's why I wanted the bat finish, because it's going to, oops, we need to go down a little bit because it's going to, there we go. I still want to put that in front there. So there you've got your bouquet. I just need to add, and see, it'll stand up above. That's what I wanted it to do for the flowers. We've got one more thing to do. So the last thing is adding our little ladybug. So I've got her colored here. I'm just going to dip her in a little bit of glue and maybe put her right there and add a little bit of gloss to her shell. So there you have the very easy lavender to make in the Victorian garden. I can almost smell the beautiful aroma now.